Hello and welcome to Pictures and Pivot Tables. My name's Jeff, I'm glad you're here. Let's just jump right in. In this video, we're gonna show how we can use pictures in cells, in other words, pictures as cell values inside of Pivot Tables. Let's just get started. Exercise one. All right, so the first step was to create my little icons table. And so what I did was I took the weather description and I inserted these pictures into the cells. The way that I did that is I went to Insert, Illustrations, Pictures, Place in Cells, and then I browsed to my local device and I inserted each of these pictures. Now that these pictures are stored in cells as cell values, I can use them in formulas. So for example, let's say I wanted to retrieve these icons into this weather data table. You can use your favorite lookup function, VLOOKUP, index match, XLOOKUP, whatever. I'm gonna go with XLOOKUP and I'm gonna go find this weather, comma, in here, comma, and I'm gonna return this icon, close function, and enter. And now I have these pictures that represent the weather for the day. So now that these are cell values, can we use them like in pivot tables? I don't know, let's find out. Exercise two. In this exercise, we're gonna create a pivot table. So let's go back to exercise one. We'll select any cell within the range, insert pivot table from table range. We want to add the pivot table to an existing worksheet. Exercise two, pick a cell and click OK. Now what we see in our pivot table fields is we have date, city, high, low, weather, and the icon column. So like what, can we actually insert this icon column into a pivot table? Yeah, into the rows or columns layout area. So check it out. Let me insert icon into the rows layout area. And now maybe we want to count the number of days. So we can insert date into the values layout area. And now we get the count of the number of days for each of these weather conditions. And let's just play around. Maybe we want to see it by city. So we could do that. Maybe we want to see city over here and icon up here. So you can see this icon field is just a normal pivot table field. So I can put icon into columns. I can put icon into rows. Now I could also put city up here. I could put icon here. And if I wanted the weather description, I could certainly put it in here as well. And then I can change my report layout to tabular. I can remove subtotals and I can take off the row column headers and I can take off the plus minus buttons. So as you can see, by having a picture in a cell and being able to insert that into a pivot table, it opens up a lot of really interesting possibilities. Hey, hopefully this is helpful. Thanks so much for joining me. Have a great day. Hey, Excel user. If you ever need to create summary reports, check out my Pivot Table for Beginners video. It starts at the beginning and shows how to store the data transactions in a table and then how to summarize those transactions with a pivot table report. I hope it helps unlock the incredible power of pivot tables.
This video is a production of Excel University.